I've got wrong, because they definitely are. But let's go straight into it. So starting with Arsenal. Say of course, but he did miss about 3 months of the season with injury, so you know it's a bit dodgy me giving it to him. You could have said Ollie Watkins maybe, but I've gone for Grealish. He's got 12 goals and 6 assists in 26 games in the Premier League, and as I said, he was missing for 3 months, but you could see the impact. Aston Villa completely fell off in those 3 months without Jack Grealish, and he is going to be important for Villa if they can keep hold of him. For Brighton, I've gone for Yves Bissouma. This one was quite tough. There were quite a few people I could have picked, maybe Ben White, the goalie Diego Sanchez. I feel he's been the most consistent over the season, and he's been a real great addition to that midfield, and has really helped them in staying up this season. And rightfully so, he's being linked now with moves away to the likes of Arsenal and Liverpool. But yeah, I think it's a really consistent, solid season. For Burnley, I've gone for James Tarkowski. Now this one, a lot of people would say Chris Wood, who got 12 league goals, which is pretty impressive considering he plays for Burnley. However, I saw the stat and it said 80% of his 12 goals came in one game at Wolves. So yeah, I'm not sure I can really put him in there, and it's kind of towards the back end of the season he put no goals up. But I've gone for Dorcos because they lacked that consistent back line which they've built their success on. Saha, a lot of people don't realise this, but he's of his career in a season, and he gets a goal every three games. So, and it's, he's hit double figures for, I think, the second time in his career. So credit to him, he's really stepped up in front of goal. So I've picked him. Everton of Dominic Calvert-Lewin. He had a brilliant start, scoring so many goals. It dried up a little, however, it levelled off, and he got 16 Premier League goals, which is a really good return. And he's the main man for Everton. They rely on him. They play, or they did play, to his strengths. You know, they played long ball, get the balls on the box. So that's what I've gone for him. Fulham. I've gone for Andre Frank Sambo and Gisa. This one was quite hard, because there wasn't really many. I could have gone Yogi Mandersen, but he was really inconsistent. I've seen him have some really poor games. They went Areola, made some bad mistakes. So I've gone for Sambo and Gisa, because I think he was probably, I wouldn't say he's consistent, but he was probably the least inconsistent, if you know what I mean. And I think he's shown real bright sparks in that midfield, but unfortunately he couldn't keep them up. But I expect him to move away. I think it's too good for the championship. Leeds, I've gone for Patrick Bamford. I could have gone Rafinha. A lot of people would. He finished fourth in the goal scoring charts, which I think is exceptional. I don't think anyone actually expected that from him. When the season started, many doubts about him, but he's proved that doubt is wrong, and I think I'm gonna have to go and play for the season for that. Leicester, I've gone Wesley Fofana. Nacho, but he is the player of the season. He performed in the last 3 months of the season. He didn't score a goal until February, so I can't really give it to him for that. But Wesley Fofana has he's had a really consistent season. He, when Leicester bought him, not many people knew about him, and then Swanju, I think, got an injury. He came into the side and instantly slotted in, and he's been a great player, and he will be a great player in the future. Now for Liverpool, I've gone for Mohamed Salah. I think this one was quite obvious. You know, nobody, Mane, Firmino, they all had poor seasons. Hopefully Van Dijk and Henderson and all that got injured, so weren't really anyone else to challenge Mo Salah, who was one goal away from getting another golden boot and scored 22 league goals. So I think very obvious one there. Manchester City, I've gone Ruben Diaz. He won player of the year, I believe, and it's deserved. He came into the side, which was one of their biggest frailties, was the defence. Everyone thought they could get at them on the counter with that defence. And then Ruben Diaz comes in, him and Stones at the back. He just completely solidified it and has helped them storm to the league title. And now for Manchester United, it's pretty easy one again. Bruno Fernandes, 18 goals, 12 assists in the Premier League. That's brilliant. You know, since he's joined Man U, he's had such an impact, and he's basically he's the main man at Man United, and has driven them to second place. So an easy one there. Newcastle, I've gone for Callum Wilson. There wasn't many. Another option was maybe Joe Willock, but he came in January, so again, managed to score 12 goals in quite a defensive team. So I think that's very impressive. And you could see when he wasn't there, Newcastle were awful. They had no one to put the ball in the back of the net. So he's really helped them survive. Sheffield United, this one was so bad. It was so hard to choose. But I've gone for David McGoldrick. Nobody really standed out. However, David McGoldrick scored 8 goals. And that was 8 out of 20 goals Sheffield United scored all season. So I guess he's been the talisman despite last year not really having much in terms of goals, but I think he can be pleased with his efforts this season. Southampton, I've gone for James Ward-Prowse. It's been a weird season for the Southampton. They were doing wonders at the start of the season, then it all kind of fell off. Danny Ings hasn't had an amazing season, but I've gone Ward-Prowse. He's played every minute in the league for the past 2 seasons now, and he's adding goals now with his free kicks, which everyone knows about. He's a good creative player, and he's really the heartbeat of that midfield. For Tottenham, the easiest one on the list, Harry Kane. He got the Golden Boot Award, the Playmaker Award as well. And yeah, he's been exceptional this season. I guess a shout out to Son, he's had a decent year as well. It was looking like they were gonna challenge for the league at one point. Their season completely fell off, but his form stayed. So fair play to him. West Brom now. I could have gone Matheus Pereira, who had some excellent spells, but he was just too inconsistent. So I've gone for someone who's been consistent, and it's Sam Johnstone. They conceded 76 goals, however, he pulled off some wonder saves, and I think without him, it could have been about 100 goals, if I'm being honest. Their defence was awful, but he has managed to keep it down a bit, and he's rightfully so earned himself an England call-up, so I think he might get a move back into the Premier League as well. West Ham, I've gone for Thomas Souček. This one was hard. I could have done Declan Rice, maybe Jesse Lingard. However, he hasn't been there for the entire campaign, and I feel Thomas Souček, I picked him over Rice simply because I think his goal threat has been so huge for them. You know, he works so hard in the midfield, he's a brilliant tackler, but he also, him and Rice, they're the right balance, and I think Souček, with the goals and his height, it adds a different dimension for West Ham this season, and he's been brilliant in helping them qualify for Europe. And now the last one, we've got Wolves, and I've picked Pedro Neto. He's looked brilliant at times this season, and he's added that kind of spark which Wolves have needed. He stepped up after Jota left. He didn't necessarily score loads of goals, and he got an injury. However, it's been an underwhelming season for Wolves and Pedro Neto. However, it's going to be a star in the future, I'm sure of it. But there we have it. There are my player of the seasons.